the one thing that I'm having a tough time even getting past, and you mentioned how you sparred with him for 12 rounds, which is great. But that said, I mean, when you're in the spotlight, in the glare, and you got Floyd Mayweather doing the throwing and the punching and the cat and mouse, this is just not even close to anything that Conor has come to in terms of endurance, in terms of how long something can last. How can he possibly get ready for something like that, even with training, Paul?
Well, here's the thing. I mean, Conor has a guy that, especially the first time you see him, you're probably going to get weird angles and weird shots that you haven't seen before. Like the first time I boxed him a couple weeks ago, it took me a few rounds to really get settled in and be like, you know, what is this guy doing? You know what I mean? Because at first you'll see him and you'll think the guy doesn't even know what he's doing, you know? But then you start to realize he knows how to make it work for him. And so then you have to kind of adapt to it and start to get the timing of it and so on and so forth. So, you know, I believe early on in that fight is Conor's best opportunity. Not so much as much as people think where he just got to rush Floyd. I don't think it's so much that he has to rush Floyd. But I just think Conor's just unorthodox style will take a few rounds to kind of adjust to Floyd Mayweather. And those rounds that Floyd's trying to adjust, I mean, Floyd knows how to adjust without getting reckless, so he's not going to get reckless. But while he's trying to adjust, maybe Conor can have him on the back foot a little bit and apply some pressure and apply some of the stuff he wants to do. And also, I don't think it's just down to the early part of the fight. I think late in the fight, if Conor is able to land decent shots during the fight, he's able to have some of those moments that I spoke about earlier, here and there and here and there. Maybe late in the fight, you know, a 40-year-old Mayweather is a little bit tired, a little bit fatigued. These are all big maybes. But if late in the fight, Mayweather is tired or fatigued, then you know, the younger, fresher Conor McGregor can try to, you know, put some hurt on him late in the fight as well. Again, these are all big maybes, these are all big ifs, but they all definitely have to be spoken about.
They're all possibilities, yeah. I mean, we had Dominic Cruz here last week. He thought that if he didn't get it done in the first six rounds, though, that would be the problem, that he's got to get Floyd in the first six rounds, and that Conor knows that.
I don't think it's that black and white, because even if you don't get Floyd out of there in the first six rounds, but what if you've done enough damage to Floyd in the first six rounds to where now you're going to slow him down for 10, 11, and 12, you know? And again, like I said before, these are big ifs, these are big maybes, but that's why I don't necessarily say it's not that black and white. I think there's a lot of gray area in there as well, because it's not just the first six rounds, it's how those first six rounds are played out as well. Are you making the champion Mayweather? Are you making Mayweather expend enough energy? Are you taking enough gasoline out of the tank of Mayweather? You know, even if you don't get him out of there, you know, there's other little subtleties you have to look for within those first five, six rounds. If Conor doesn't get him out, that maybe he can play along, can play to his advantage later in the fight. But again, Mayweather's 40. Mayweather's 42 years. You know, that's not some. You have to put some of that into consideration.
So are you in the rotation of sparring? How many are there?
There's a handful of guys. You know, I'm probably the biggest name sparring partner here. You know, then you have like one of the mill guys. You have an amateur fighter named Kieran Bradley, who's from Ireland, who's a good high-level amateur fighter. There's Deshaun Johnson, who's been who's done some boxing and mixed martial arts. You know, he's a little bit of a journeyman, but has been in with some of the best fighters. You know, and then there's another mixed martial artist, a couple mixed martial artists that sometimes he throws in on the end of sparring. One guy named Franz and one guy named Artem. You know, he usually uses them sporadically, you know, just to kind of fill out the rounds if he doesn't get enough rounds from the boxers. But last night was just me and him for 12 rounds.
When's the next time you're scheduled to spar with Conor?
I don't know. It's not that cut and dry. He's kind of weird like that. He doesn't let you know really until like maybe a day before.
Come on. Seriously? What
does
he text you? Do you get a text?
No, his team will let us know, you know, because we're at a sparring partners, we're in a separate house.
The one thing that I'm having a tough time even getting past, and you mentioned how you sparred with him for 12 rounds, which is great. But that said, I mean, when you're in the spotlight, in the glare, and you got Floyd Mayweather doing the throwing and the punching and the cat and mouse, this is just not even close to anything that Conor has come to in terms of endurance, in terms of how long something can last. How can he possibly get ready for something like that, even with training, Paul?
Well, here's the thing. I mean, Conor has a guy that, especially the first time you see him, you're probably going to get weird angles and weird shots that you haven't seen before. Like the first time I boxed him a couple weeks ago, it took me a few rounds to really get settled in and be like, you know, what is this guy doing? You know what I mean? Because at first you'll see him and you'll think the guy doesn't even know what he's doing, you know? But then you start to realize he knows how to make it work for him. And so then you have to kind of adapt to it and start to get the timing of it and so on and so forth. So, you know, I believe early on in that fight is Conor's best opportunity. Not so much as much as people think where he just got to rush Floyd. I don't think it's so much that he has to rush Floyd. But I just think Conor's just unorthodox style will take a few rounds to kind of adjust to Floyd Mayweather. And those rounds that Floyd's trying to adjust, I mean, Floyd knows how to adjust without getting reckless, so he's not going to get reckless. But while he's trying to adjust, maybe kind of have him on the back foot a little bit and apply some pressure and apply some of the stuff he wants to do. And also, I don't think it's just down to the early part of the fight. I think late in the fight, if Conor is able to land decent shots during the fight, he's able to have some of those moments that I spoke about earlier here.